So over the week of Christmas, I had COVID, and looking back on it, I got it in probably the least responsible way possible, especially considering I live in New York City. Now, look, we're almost 2 years into this pandemic, okay? And the original COVID variant, I worked for a majority of that time. I didn't get COVID at all, okay? The Delta variant came and went, and I worked the entire time public facing, and I didn't get that that variant either. I got vaccinated back in April, you know, first and second dose. I hadn't gotten my booster shot yet. I was planning on getting it after this holiday season because I didn't want to, you know, be sick like right around Christmas time, stuff like that. Little did I know I would actually get COVID. But anyway, if you know anything about New York City right now, it doesn't matter if you got a booster shot because literally everyone has it, okay? And I'm not making this video to be political. I don't care if you get whatever, it doesn't matter, okay? I'm just here to tell my story, and maybe some of you guys can relate, okay? So look, the beginning of December, New York City gets the first confirmed case of the Omicron variant, okay? And again, Delta came and went. It wasn't, you know, it was a big deal for some people. I didn't get it regardless of coming in contact with all of Queens, okay, for months. So we don't know much about the new variant at the time. And to me, I'm like, okay, one case, and there's what, how many millions of people in New York? Like, you know, it's a big deal. Obviously, we've been in a pandemic forever. We know that, you know, it's a big deal at this point, but still, you know, one case, like it's one case, you know what I mean? So a couple weeks later, okay, it's a Saturday, and me and my roommate decide that we're gonna go to a concert because, you know what, we went to Izu in September. Okay, there's a 3-day festival. There's like 40,000 people there. Okay, no, pretty much no masks, let's be real. They checked for vaccination at the gate. You got a little wristband, and then boom, you were just good to go. You could just do whatever you wanted. It didn't matter. And trust me, people did whatever they wanted. And we were, I mean, I've never been that close to 40,000 people. Okay. You would not think that there was a pandemic going on at all. All right. So we went there, we survived that. And so here, you know, it's December, there's a concert we want to go to, and you know, let's go. Like, why not? Let's go. In hindsight, okay, that was probably not a good strategy. Probably not a good strategy, okay? But you know, hindsight's always 2020. So, oh my God, hindsight's 2020. And 2020 is, I'm not gonna make a corny joke. Anyway, in case you're not familiar with the, you know, the current situation here in New York, okay? Things have kind of gotten out of control in the last couple of weeks. Like realistically, like literally everybody has COVID right now, okay? The new Omicron variant, just, it's easy to get, it's everywhere, everyone's got it, okay? But right around here, you know, the time where we went to the concert, not crazy, okay? Nothing, you know, obviously it would have been better around this area here, but okay, it wasn't insane at this point, okay? So we go to the concert. Next day, everything's fine. I don't have work that day, so I'm chilling. I'm also off the following Monday. Everything is cool. Tuesday, birthday for my roommate, okay? First thing in the morning, he texts me. He says, "Hey, I feel like I just got hit by a truck." And I'm like, "Oh, okay. What do you mean by that?" He says that, you know, he can't get up, he can't move, he feels like shit. So I'm like, "Okay, I'm gonna do the responsible thing because we did just go to a concert a couple days ago. So I'm gonna go and get tested." And let me tell you, the lines to get tested for COVID in New York City right now are literally the span of an entire city block. Like, it is actually insane, especially considering the fact that it's freezing cold out, okay? And everybody is in a panic because it's, at that time, it was almost Christmas, couple days before, and everybody's gonna, they have plans to travel, and suddenly this new variant just completely infected the entire city all at once, pretty much. So I go to down the street, and I'm looking for a place to get tested. All these lines, I kid you not, every single block had probably two testing tents on every single block, and each one was a block long. And I'm like, oh my God, this is insane. So I went a little bit farther into Queens, okay, a little bit closer to like the Long Island City area, and I'm looking for a place that maybe isn't in the middle of a ton of people, because where I live in this part of Queens, and I'm not gonna, you know, give away too much information, but where I live right here, there's a big density of people. So I'm trying to go a little bit to where there's a lower density of population, thinking maybe there'll just be less foot traffic and therefore maybe there will be shorter lines. But unfortunately, that was not the case. I went all the way out of my way to go to a testing location that I thought would be a bit more remote, and that wasn't the case. It was all the way down the block, and I thought, okay, I'm already here. How long could this possibly take? A test is just boom, boom, up the nose, and you're good. So I wait online, and the line starts to move, you know, it's moving, and I'm making progress, and I'm thinking, okay, like, you know, this will be like an hour, like no big deal. I'll wait an hour. It's fine. It's the responsible thing to do. at that time I did not have symptoms, but my roommate did, and I figured, hey, you know, if he's sick, we live together, we hang out together, I probably, you know, I'm a high risk of being in close contact. So I'm waiting in line, an hour goes by, I gotta pee, I hadn't had coffee yet, okay? So if you're a caffeine addict like me, you know that headache starts to set in, and all of a sudden everything pisses you off. So the last thing you want to do is stand in a line full of sick people, you know, a couple days before Christmas in New York City, weather, it's freezing out, okay? And I'm worried that, okay, maybe now I have COVID. So an hour goes by, 2 hours go by, and I'm getting close to the front, but the line is not moving as quickly as I thought it was. So I think there was an illusion of progress because the line was so long that the gap between people just started getting shorter and shorter. I thought we were making progress. Turns out we weren't. So finally, after 3 hours, I start to feel achy. Like my back is aching, my hips kind of ache. And now I'm thinking, well, I mean, I just stood in the cold for 3 hours. Obviously I'm going to feel like shit, right? So I go in there, I get a rapid test, I get a PCR test, and I'm out. I go home, I eat a bagel, I have my coffee, and I take a nap. I wake up later that day and I'm still feeling pretty achy. And I'm like, okay, that's a little weird. I just took like a 2 hour nap. Normally I would feel fine by now, but I'm still kind of feeling a little achy. The apartment's feeling a little bit warm, you know? And so then I'm getting a little bit worried. My roommate is, for all intents and purposes, deceased in his bedroom. I hadn't seen him all day, okay? So I'm texting him, making sure that he's still alive and all that good stuff. And I'm just going about my day. You know, luckily I'm pretty much introverted. I like to make YouTube videos and sit in my room. So realistically, the pandemic doesn't change too much for your boy. So at the end of the day, that evening, I'm laying in bed watching some bullshit on YouTube. Doesn't matter. I was down a rabbit hole and I'm feeling pretty warm. I'm like, okay, this is like, I took the blankets off, still feeling kind of hot. I take my temperature, 'cause I have one of those little, the gun thingies. I take the temperature and it's almost at 100. So it's flashing. It's yellow. It's not red. It's not like, oh my God, you're burning up, but it's in the yellow territory where it's like, hey, this isn't like a normal temperature for you. So I text my roommate and I'm saying, hey, I'm achy. I'm like a borderline fever right now. I think I might be sick as well. By the way, my rapid test, I got texted, right? It came back negative. Rapid test came back negative. So I'm thinking, okay, you know, it's day of negative test. I know that they're not that reliable, but this is a good sign at least, right? It's a good sign. It's not positive. So, hey, that's great. Next day comes, wake up, fever. Sick. I'm so stoked about that. Really happy that I'm not feeling well. My roommate's still not feeling well, but he at least can get up and move around the apartment, all that good stuff. So I text him. I said, hey, I got a fever, super achy back, all that stuff sucks. So at that point, I don't have a loss of taste. I don't have a loss of smell. I almost wish I did because I've gained 13 pounds in the last few months. I know a little bit too much information there, but I've been gaining weight lately. So, you know, hey, if I'm going to have COVID, it would have been nice to not crave cheeseburgers and shit. Okay. But unfortunately, I still had all the cravings and everything still tasted delicious. None of those symptoms. I had no trouble breathing at all. Okay. Everything was fine, except I was just really achy with a fever. And occasionally I'd have a cough here and there. So I'm thinking, okay, I probably have the flu, right? Because let's be real, as much as COVID's a big deal, the flu is still like a thing, right? Like people still get the flu. The flu is still around and I don't have the flu shot. So, you know, I could have the flu and that would be, you know, that'd be a reasonable explanation. So I'm thinking, okay, I have the flu. That sucks, but hey, at least it's not COVID, right? Because the rapid test came back negative. So that day, because my roommate was feeling better, he went and got tested himself. He just got a PCR test and a flu test because he was thinking the same thing. So he gets his test done. We feel like garbage. We go to bed that day. I have a fever all night. I wake up the next day, still have a fever, right? So now we're like 2.5 days in, still have a fever, mild fever, nothing crazy, right? Like I can still sit here and do whatever, super achy back, all that stuff, but no new symptoms. We're stuck inside for like the third day in a row. We're going kind of a little bit crazy. As you guys know, if you live in New York, the weather here sucks. So it's super like gloomy out. It gets dark at like fucking 2:30. So it's just depressing, right? And it's supposed to be like Christmas time, right? I think this was like Christmas Eve that this was the case. And at that point I realized like, hey, I'm not gonna be able to see my family for Christmas. It's the responsible thing to do. Even if I got a negative rapid test, you know, who knows, right? And even if it's the flu, probably not a good idea to travel and also see my parents and my family. That, you know, it is what it is. So roommate gets his PCR test back in like a day because he went to his provider, like his general, you know, physician, and somehow he got his test back in like a day, positive. So now we know, okay, my roommate definitely has it, and I live with him. We've been quarantined together for a couple days. I'm just assuming that because we have the same symptoms, we probably have the same thing, right? So I'm thinking, okay, even though my rapid test was negative, his PCR is positive, so I'm probably doing, you know, probably the same deal. So a couple days goes by, you know, no new symptoms, no new anything. I took another rapid test because it's required to go back for work. And at that point I had like, you know, I was fine. I had like the whole time, and I think I forgot to mention this, but the entire time from the day that I started getting achy, I had a headache, like behind my eyes, headache all day, all night, every single day for like 5 days straight. I took ibuprofen, I took Tylenol, I took whatever. I just had a dull headache all the time. So anyway, near the tail end, probably around around the 6 day mark is when I had pretty much no symptoms, random cough and like a slight headache, but everything else was fine. I hadn't had a fever, I hadn't had any aches or anything like that. So I think I'm in the clear at that point. That was also when the CDC said that a 5 day quarantine was all you need. So I'm like, okay, not bad. I get a rapid test done. Rapid test comes back positive. I'm like, ooh, that's interesting. So now that I'm feeling better, I'm testing positive. That's annoying. So at that point, it's confirmed. Okay, even though my rapid test, my original one, came back negative, my first PCR test also came back negative. Same day that I started developing symptoms, came back negative. And you know, now the rest is sort of history. That was like a week ago. Everything is fine. I have no symptoms, no lasting symptoms, it seems. Let me knock on wood here. I seem to be okay. So, you know, I'm glad that maybe the vaccine helped me a little bit. I know I got it a while ago, but I'm thinking probably better than nothing, right? At least to have it introduced into my system. I don't know, okay? And let's be real, neither do you. Nobody knows what's real anymore anyway. And that's kind of part of the problem. So anyway, New York right now is completely everyone's, it's like the new hip thing is to get Omicron right now. So if you guys live in a major city, you're planning on traveling here for the new year, I would advise you to just be careful, because some of these big cities, man, everybody has it. There's cases where people work from home, they don't have any friends, and they're still somehow getting it. And I don't understand it. Like, is it in the drinking? What, you know what? I shouldn't even play. I shouldn't even make jokes like that. Cause some of y'all out there really believe it. Y'all really think that. I'm kidding. Anyway, guys, I hope you're having a happy and healthy new year. Hopefully you found this video a little bit informative so I could share with you my experience. So that way, if you end up getting sick, you kind of have my perspective as to how I felt, because I didn't have some of the same symptoms that a lot of people do end up getting. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to be responsible. Don't go to concerts like an idiot. Okay. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.